In this video, we will be demonstrating how to perform a quantitative transfer of a solution of Kool-Aid. A quantitative transfer is used to transfer the entirety of a solution from one vessel to another without losing any analyte in the process. You will use quantitative transfers often when working in the chemistry laboratory. To begin, we add the solid into a 400 milliliter beaker. Note that the volume markers on the beaker are for estimation only, and give an approximate volume within 5 milliliters of the actual volume. Next, we add 20 milliliters of water using a graduated cylinder. While graduated cylinders can measure volumes more accurately than a beaker, they are still considered estimates and should not be used when an exact volume is needed. Stir with a glass rod to ensure that all of the Kool-Aid is dissolved. Sometimes more solvent may be needed to dissolve all of the solid. Beakers should never be filled more than 65% of their total volume, as they can become difficult to manipulate. To aid with the transfer, set up a retort stand with a ring clamp. The clamp should be firmly screwed, but not so tight that it requires excessive force to unscrew. Carefully place a short stem funnel inside the ring clamp. You should never place a funnel directly into a volumetric flask without a clamp, as it can easily tip over the flask. Adjust the position of the ring clamp so that the funnel tip rests inside the volumetric flask, approximately 2 to 3 centimeters. Now, pour the Kool-Aid solution down a glass rod into the volumetric flask. The purpose of the glass rod is to prevent splashing of the solution outside of the volumetric flask. When a glass rod is not used, then splashing is more likely to occur. Notice how some of the solution is lost. Once the beaker is empty, you will notice that some residue remains in the beaker. If this is discarded, then the solution was not completely transferred. To ensure complete transfer, rinse the beaker with a small amount of fresh solvent and transfer the rinse to the volumetric flask. Volumetric flasks are used to make solutions of accurate volumes within 0.01 to 0.05 milliliters. The flask in our example will make a solution which is exactly 100 milliliters in volume. Repeat the rinse until no residue is visible on the beaker. Finally, rinse the solution adhering to the stirring rod and rinse and remove the funnel. It is important to be aware of how much fresh solvent you are using to rinse the beaker and glass rod. Remember, we are trying to make a 100 ml solution. Using too much will result in a volume that is too large, making the solution unusable. Carefully fill the volumetric flask until the solution is 1 to 2 centimeters below the etched mark. Remember to be careful when doing this, as the volumetric flask will fill up faster than you think. Once the level of the solution is 1 to 2 centimeters below the line, remove the funnel and use a passer pipette to carefully fill the flask until the bottom of the meniscus is resting on the etch calibration mark when read at eye level. Remember, the volumetric flask must be on a flat surface to accurately read the meniscus. Stopper and invert the flask 15 to 20 times to make sure the solution is fully mixed. Hold the stopper while inverting to ensure it remains securely in place.